नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा सम्बुद्धस्स। Dear venerables, dear devotees, today we completed the third day of our intensive meditation practice. Most of the venerables we see, they are more effortful, they are more intense. Their practice, the effortful practice. The intensive focusing very important. The practice development for you. How about the advice for us to develop practice? The development for us. If you are heedful, if you are apamada, if you are effortful practice, so developments may be 1 day, 2 days, or few days, your developments come. Until the development comes, we have to maintain. So within these 10 days, we maintain effortful practice. It is very important. You can experience deeper calmness, comfortableness, and results. So until the results come, our effort, we should not reduce. So most of the venerables, we see effortful. So we have to maintain this intensive background, the silent background. And also we have to maintain, continuously follow our schedules. So the determination together, we practice. We wish all the venerables to fulfill this practice and attain deeper concentrations and attain deeper path, portions and nibbana. In the Lord Buddha time, many they could attain path, portions. Many they could practice. Ordained one, also they practice and attain. And also devotees, also same. Reason is, few reasons. One thing is the Buddha. Buddha's parami is very high. Cannot equal to the other people in the world. Highest parami person in the world. So Buddha arise. It's Buddha's parami power. Anyone see the Buddha, anyone hear the Buddha, they feel or follow Buddha. Because of Parami's power. Reason is many lives Buddha had been helping others for Dhamma developments. So this one thing. Another thing is Buddha's teaching way. Very simplest teaching Buddha teach, even the very deep Dhamma. Buddha teach in very simplest way. And any background people they can understand. Even the lowest education or highest education, or that in the rich background or poor background, any background, all they can absorb the Buddha's teaching, all they can understand Buddha's teaching, because of Buddha's teaching very simple. So many, they could get the Buddha's teaching and understand. Another reason is they are parami. Listeners' parami is very high in the Buddha time. So they also, many of them, that to complete their parami to attainment path portion. So for high parami people, high parami venerables, they listen from the Buddha, they feel or follow their practice, many of them they practice, many of them they could attain path portions. So they are in that time, one of the venerable, he also ordained to the Sambuddha Sasana. After that, venerable also had been learning all the basic things under the Buddha and Sangha. Then he think, practice alone. His, near his relative's place is good place for the venerable to practice. The venerable selected the nearer relative's place and had been walking to the village, arms surrounding Pindapath, then had been living and practicing. Venerable is heedful. Venerable not thinking of my relative, my friends, not thinking, not attachments, but maintain ordination practice. Venerable think, I have to fulfill my mindfulness, I have to fulfill my concentration, I have to fulfill my wisdom, effortfully practice. So then on that time, The some of the venerable doubted over these venerable, living nearer their relatives but never joining any of the special dhanas. That Anatha Pindika, Visakha Mata, and also King Kosala, they are giving very big dhanas but never joining any of the these ceremonies. It is not suitable. So venerable complain, venerable bring these issues to the Buddha. And says Bhante, this venerable in living this way. Buddha asked the venerable to come. Venerable come to pay respect Lord Buddha and ask Buddha, venerable, is it true? You are living, associating your relatives, not joining any other ceremony? Yes, Bhante, it's true. The Buddha asked, what is the reason, your attachment to your families? So that venerable answer, no, Bhante, that I never have this kind of ideas. This place is suitable for me to practice. That's why I come to this area. I don't have any of the attachments. So Buddha encouraged us to remove all the attachments. I try to do it. I try to fulfill my mindfulness, concentration, wisdom. So that some days, very simplest dhana I get, I am satisfied. Some days, some good dhanas I get, I am not thinking it. Good dhana, oh, that difficult dhana, oh, I am not thinking. Whatever food I got, I eat and I live very simply. So Venerable answered to the Buddha. Buddha says, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. My sasana, venerable, my disciples had to follow this way. My disciples had to practice this way. On that time, Buddha explained one of the Jataka story. Also, then later, take one topic of Dhammapada. It is Appamadavagga last verse. And preach Dhamma to the Venerable Sangha. So on that day, the Buddha explaining. In earlier, in India, Varanasi, the one of the tree called Dimbul tree, that tree got fruits. So that one group of the parrots, they had been living on that tree. So Jataka story, Buddha had been explaining. So that parrots groups, they are living on that tree. Tree got fruits, that you know the many fruits. So the king of the parrot and also others together had been living. Sometimes later got very big drought, no enough raining. So that other parrot says, now our food is reducing. We go to the another place. That the king parrot says, I like to stay in the same place. Whatever your food is enough for me. Better you go and find another place for you to eat. So he sent other parrots. That king only now stay in there. Later gradually tree become dry. That means all the leaves also disappear, fruits also disappear. Then parrots only, king only live in there. King Sakka, he got warm up his sitting place, see what is the reason for this parrot, very special one. Then King Sakka determined further dry this tree to see this parrot's quality. Yes, even dry now, from complete dry tree. Only eating wood, some of the wood powders, and eating and living. Very simplest way living, wood powders, because already dry now tree. So then still not going. Then King Sakka come there and appear and ask parrots, King Parrots, why you are not going to other tree? All your followers already go to the far away to find out good places. You are only living this dead one. Dead tree, eating very simplest way. Why you are doing so? Oh, that King Sakka, I like the simplest way. The simplest, I am satisfied. I am comfortable. So this simplest way. So King Sakka says, sadhu, sadhu. And then King Sakka said, I will help you. That determine not to dry this tree again. Fruits that continuously remain until whole his period there, that continuously fruit there remain. So determine King Sakka and help these parrots and go to the celestial. Buddha says that time, that parrots, King Parrots is me. bodhisattva. So that I had been trained in this kind of simplest way. That's why I became Buddha. My disciples also had to train this kind of thing. Then they can reach their liberations. That time the King Sakka is not someone else. It is King Sakka is our Venerable Ananda. So Buddha had been explaining this Jataka story and explained one of the Dhammapada to preach Dhamma to the Venerable Sangha. අපමාද රතෝ බිකෝ උපමාදේ භය දස්සෙවා අබබ්බෝ පරිහානාය නිබ්බානස්සේව සම්තිකේති. The Buddha explained one Dhammapada is අපමාද වග්ග. අපමාද රතෝ බිකෝ උපමාදේ භය දස්සෙවා. See the danger of the heedless and he practice heedfulness. Such a one. That who practice heedful, seen heedless, a danger of the heedless. Abhabbo parihanaya he, that never going downwards, not reducing power of the mental development. That means that he is not going down. Nibbana seva sanchike, he is living closer to the liberation and fulfill paramis and attainments. So this kind of explanation Buddha explained for preaching Dhamma to the Venerable Sangha. So that later we will explain the Buddha's Dhamma. So the Dhammapada explaining the appamadarato bhikkhu pamade bhaya dasseva. Pamade bhaya. See the danger of the heedless. So that why we see the danger of the heedless? What is the harmful things if we follow the heedless? We little bit see what is the danger of the heedless. First we understand heedless. So that the worldly beings, they born with the greed and hatred, delusion. They based on the defilement base. Whoever born in the world, they are based greed. So that other defilements also they are base. So they are living also together with the great hatred, delusion, conceit, the wrong views, this background. So they are growing up with this background and also they are maturing together with this background, aging together with this background. So that worldly beings, they are allowed to maintain this great hatred, delusion, conceit, all these defilements, they allow and continue living together with this defilement called pamada, heedless. Means we born we with the great hatred delusion, we bring up to today also great hatred delusion background, we allow continue this great hatred delusion background, we call pamada or heedless. And also another thing is they are not trying to correct their life. They have some weaknesses of their life. They not try to correct their weaknesses. They are not try to correct their mentalities to go to the focusing level. That not try to reduce their distractions. Not try to develop their understanding. In other words, not try to develop sila. Not try to develop samadhi. Not try to develop wisdom. Also pamad. Now you understand, pamada, heedless means continue the great hatred delusion is pamada. Another one is not try to that develop your moral qualities, develop your tranquil qualities, develop your wisdom qualities, not trying. This pamada. What is the danger of this pamada or heedless? If anyone living heedless, their karma background very weak. The person living as the very weak person, easy get the greed object, easy get the hatred, easy get the delusion, easy fighting, easy argument, many defilements very easy. Such a person very defiled, very easy. So living very painful, living. Die moment, getting all and die moment, cannot get proper object because karma weak, life very weak, die moment very weak life. So cannot see where they are going. Sometimes very rarely can go to the human, but most of the time go to the hell lives, animal lives and hell lives. Many suffering lives. So life to life, continue with this greed, hatred, delusion. Samsara is very long, had to suffer a lot. The present life, we have many suffering. So the present life suffering and future samsara suffering is also more and more I had to suffer because of the heedless practice. Because of the pamada. Pamada person is suffering today, tomorrow, dying moment, next life, because they don't have proper karma, they don't have proper life, they don't have proper that energies. They have to suffer. Had to see, oh danger, this life, this way living, danger. Pamada living, danger. Had to see. So after seeing that this danger, they had to correct their mentalities, they had to correct their life, or determine and to correct our that weaknesses. We have weaknesses, many weaknesses of life, we have to correct those weaknesses. It's called moral qualities. And also we try to develop concentration qualities and also try to develop wisdom qualities. This training we try to develop is called the appamada. So the now we understand pamada, heedless, is danger. Heedful, the Buddha says, practice heedful. What is heedful? We try to correct our life. We have many weaknesses of our life. Even we ordain, we have some weaknesses. Sometimes we are talking unnecessary, our weakness. Sometimes we are blaming others. We are talking ill of others. It is our weaknesses. So that, that sometimes our action not correct. It is our weaknesses. We don't have humbleness. We don't have respectfulness. It is our weaknesses. Those things we have to correct. So that we train good qualities of life. This called sila quality. So that we're not expecting external or any of the benefits, or you're not expecting any of the good names or any of the titles, we're not expecting. So that a weak one, heedless one, only they are expecting external things. But wiseful one, they are not expecting external things, they are expecting internal good qualities, humble, respectful, and also that contentments, these kind of good qualities they are training. You know, Vijayanavansa Mahathera is very good life, very contented, very simple life. So that that many titles, these things wanted to give to Bhante, Vijayanavansa Mahathera, never. Says, I don't want, rejected. Someone, other venerable, they collect those things, but Vijayanavansa Mahathera never collect those things. So very simple life. And also keep humble and also keep mindful life. Like that, ordination power is increasing with these moral qualities. We have to train moral quality. Even our enemies also together, we have to live with the simplest way. This is called moral qualities. It is very important to develop. We have to find out our weaknesses, how to correct. And also our mental distractions, many. We try to reduce these distractions and try to concentrate to the one object. It is not easily concentrate, but gradually we can do. Beginning we concentrate only 1 second. You 1 second, you concentrate with your object, it is enough. Then gradually increase 2 second, 5 second, 30 second, 1 minute, you can concentrate. It is enough. If 30 second, 1 minute, your concentrating power, gradually can increase 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hour concentration. Gradually only can come up. No one can, very rarely only some people can, no one can, others cannot immediately concentrate. So we have to try 5 second concentration, 10 second concentration. Like that, gradually you can increase your level. This way, the wiseful one, they develop their concentrations. If anyone train these moral qualities, if anyone train these tranquil qualities, concentration qualities, they are greed level reducing, hatred level reducing, delusion level reducing, conceit level reducing, wrong view level reducing, other departments reducing, life power become better and better. So ordination life or practice in life, we have to understand hateful and we have to train this hateful practice. So moral development, we know valuability. Concentration development, also we know the valuability. Your greed-hated delusion reducing. So Buddha says, Panya development. What is Panya? Wisdom. So the wisdom development. Wisdom is mainly two types, mundane and supramundane. So mundane part is general wisdom. You can develop up to the good levels. Also living system very good. Supramundane means ultimate developments. You are training your mentalities, materialities, and understand detailly is called wisdom for liberations. So this wisdom is also two type. It's general and detail. General one, you can understand this body. Body is material. This mind is mentalities. Is general. That wisdom not deep enough. Also valuable, but not deep enough. So detailed wisdom is very important. Body contain 28 type of material, ultimate material. So this further, when you are contemplating, you can see your eye base, 63 materials. Ear base, 63 materials. And also about nose base, tongue base, also 63 materials. Body base, 53 materials. Heart base, also 63 materials. All detailed understand, have to understand. Have to analyze all these materials. So whole body clearly understand is called material part, then mental part. Also we have to understand 89 type mentalities and also 52 type of mental factors. So many mentalities, many mental factors we have to understand. This understanding is called mentality, maturity understand. If these things very clear, then you have to understand this, all these mentalities, materialities, impermanent, all the time changing, impermanent, all the time changing, impermanent, cannot keep it, so it's suffering. Those mentalities, materialities, we cannot control it, nature only control it, non-self, anicca, dukkha, anatta, understand. And also these mentalities, materialities arise in passing away, udayavaya, also have to understand. If this knowledge there, all the mentalities, materialities, ultimate knowledge, and also arising, passing away, impermanent, suffering, non-self, knowledge there, so that type of wisdom, development, life become very comfortable, very relaxed, joyful life. Such a life, if anyone have greed, hatred, delusion, conceit, all the defilements, power, getting decay and decay and decay, dissolve, 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 and disappearing. So complete disappearing. So life is become very peaceful. This condition called liberation. So develop more of the wisdom, complete the wisdom. So all the defilements, decay, 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 and dissolve, dissolve, and disappearing is called liberations. If anyone train this practice, so they can live very comfortably before liberation, also very comfortable. It's very near the liberation. So after fulfill paramis, can attain path proshas. So we should determine, now it is very clear now, Buddha's teaching is why Buddha teach us to develop moral qualities, why Buddha teach us to develop the tranquil qualities, why Buddha teach us to develop the wisdom qualities, we understand. So we all had to practice it for. So apamada only can develop it. We develop apamada and we fulfill this practice and we try to train continuously during these 10 days and experience this deeper practice, and wish all of us may able to attain all the path, proshas nippan. So the Buddha explained hateful practice. We now know valuability of the hateful practice. We know our venerables, they are more practiced heatfully. Many of the venerables already results, they have the results because of the heatful practice. Further, we have to determine to continue our practice. Later, you can experience deeply their concentration, deeply wisdom, then you will be more happy. Now, little bit follow Dhamma and you feel your life more happier. So later, more follow your Dhamma, more experience with Dhamma, your life will be more happier. That time you feel more confident of the Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha, more confident of this practice. Till then, we have to keep this effortful practice. Then we know our venerable, they are more working very hard. So continuously we have to maintain this appamada, hateful practice. So that later you can experience deeply that defilementless mentalities. And also comfortable mentalities. So we wish all the venerables to fulfill this practice. We wish all the venerables to attain all the path, process and nibbana. So the venerables, they are mentioning that the disturbances from the other venerables, if there are many complaints, so that in the box, so that some of the venerables, they are disturbing, so that we have to avoid it. But we see majority of the venerables, they are more aware of it. About 80%, 90% venerable, they are aware of. They are not doing it. Only 5%, 10% venerable doing it. Even we tell, not works. Reason is their mindfulness don't have. They are very weak mentality. They are very weak wholesome power. They are not thinking of the Sangha. They are not thinking of the practice background. They are creating akusala. But we cannot avoid it because their mentality no enough mindfulness. So immediately walking, very, very loud walking, sometimes even this meditation hall, also loud walking, don't do the loud walking. Actually, we can walk very simple way, but they are walking very noisy. Even Dhanasala also, very we can walk very simple way with the respectful of Sangha, but they are walking loudly. Sometimes taking their sitting cloth very loudly. Sometimes we changing the cloth very loudly. They are not thinking of Sangha, they are not thinking of disturbing because no mindfulness. Mindful one not like that. Mindful one think, oh, I have to walk slowly because disturbing others. I have to wear my robe very simple way because disturbing others. I have to take my sitting cloth very simple way because disturbing others. So that sometimes morning we hear some venerables walking here. Many venerables meditating lower and higher before ringing the bell. That they are going to Dhanasala, so they are wearing slippers loudly, they are walking. Actually, they can walk without this area, a little bit away, if they wake, so they are walking, so that they are not disturbing others, but they are not thinking that their shoes hear sound, hear even my room also, shoe sound. So that very loudly, they are walking, it is no good. So there we try to avoid. If not, it is akusala for us because Sangha is working very hard for meditation practice. We have to understand everyone working very hard to develop their mentalities. If we ignore it, we are not thinking it, we are not respectful it, it is harmful for us, yeah. So that developing akusala mind. So that this morning I hear one venerable on 5 o'clock drop his ball. I feel like ball, very loud sound come. So many venerables, they have been practicing, they are immediately, their attention going to the other things. So this kind of thing we have to avoid. So that this kind of the pamada things, so that we call mindfulness less things happening only all the time, only few venerables. I have investigated only few venerables all the time doing walking also very loudly. That the steps also inside the building also very loudly. So all the things, this kind of thing doing same venerable. So there we have to keep the compassion for this one. So we should keep compassion. So this wish them to correct them weaknesses. The good venerable, they have to tolerate. So that we, to the noise, we have to tolerate and we have to practice. We try to develop our mentalities with the appamada. So we wish all the venerable to fulfill their practice and attainment path portions. So we share our merits. We share our merits. Punyanamodana. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. इदंगो ज्ञाते नंगो तु सुखिता हन्तु ज्ञातयो इदंगो ज्ञाते नंगो तु सुखिता हन्तु ज्ञातयो इदंगो ज्ञाते नंगो तु सुखिता हन्तु ज्ञातयो एतावता च अम्मेहि संवतं पुण्य संपदा सब्बे देवानुमोदन्तु सब्ब संपत्ति सिद्धिया सब्बे भूतानुमोदन्तु सब्ब संपत्ति सिद्धिया सब्बे सत्तानुमोदन्तु सब्ब संपत्ति सिद्धिया आकाशट्टा च बुम्मट्टा देवानाग महिद्दिका पुण्यन्तं अनुमोदित्वा चिरं रक्खन्तु संबुद्ध शासनम् चिरं रक्खन्तु संबुद्ध देशनम् चिरं रक्खन्तु संबुद्ध सावकम् चिरं रक्खन्तु मम परन्ते अस्मिन् विहारे चारामे अधिवत्ता च देवता अनुमोदित्वा इमं पुण्यं रक्खन्तु जिनशासनम् सब्बे सत्ता च मज्जत्ता हिता च मे अनुमोदित्वा इमं पुण्यं भुज्यन्तु अमतं पदम् इमिना पुण्यकम्मेन मामे बाल सतं समागमो तु याव निब्बानपत्त्या इमिना पुण्यकम्मेन मामे बाल समागमो सतं समागमो तु याव निब्बानपत्त्या इमिना पुण्यकम्मेन मामे बाल समागमो सतं समागमो तु याव निब्बानपत्त्या इमाय धम्मानु धम्म परिपत्त्या बुद्धं पूजेमि इमाय धम्मानु धम्म परिपत्त्या धम्मं पूजेमि इमाय धम्मानु धम्म परिपत्त्या संघं पूजेमि अद्दायमाय परिपत्त्या जाति जरा मरणं मा परिमुञ्चिष्यामि कायेन वाचा चित्तेन प्रमादेन मया कथम् अच्छयं कममे बन्ते भूरि पञ्यतथागत कायेन वाचा चित्तेन प्रमादेन अच्छयं कममे धम्म सन्दिट्टिकाकानिक कायेन वाचा चित्तेन प्रमादेन मया कथम् अच्छयं कममे संग पुण्यकृत् अनुत्तर साधु साधु साधु।